Hi, I'm Daniel, a PhD student at the Smart Lab from the Computer Science Department of the University of Liverpool, and in this video I'm going to be presenting you the work Generation of GelSight Tactile Images for Sim2Real Learning, a work carried out by myself, Paolo Pauletti, and Shen Lu. The manipulation of objects is prevalent in various applications, for example, grasping tools, untangling cables, and folding pieces of garment. In these tasks, it is essential to track the state of the objects being manipulated, for instance, the shape, the pose, and the center of mass. Most methods for robotic manipulation rely on vision that allows for rapid assessment of the scene. However, vision can be affected greatly by factors like occlusion and lighting conditions, making the obtained measurements less reliable. In contrast, tactile sensing is not affected by such factors. More importantly, tactile sensing can provide rich contact information between the object and the hand. Nonetheless, tactile sensors are not as widely available as cameras. To save time and resources, robotic agents can be initially trained within simulator so that only a limited number of real experiments are required to fine-tune the model before its deployment in the real scenario. For instance, in this work shown here, an object detector is pre-trained in randomized simulation environments and then tested in the real scene. Most of these Sim2Real works train models on simulated images that are then transferred to real images. However, as initial behaviors of learning-oriented agents may be highly unpredictable, it is also desirable to construct simulated robotic setups equipped with touch sensors. There have been some number of works that simulate certain properties of touch sensors. However, the simulated sensors often suffer from low resolution or other issues. In this work, we propose a simulation method for GelSight sensors. GelSight optical tactile sensors are able to attain high-resolution tactile images by exploiting the full raw images of the elastomer deformation captured by the embedded camera, and thus the sensor has been widely applied to various perception and manipulation tasks. The GelSight sensors are built using a soft transparent membrane coated with an opaque elastic paint and placed over a rigid transparent glass, as we can see here in A and B. When an object is pressed against the tactile membrane, as shown in C and D, the soft elastomer distorts and the geometry of the object is indented onto the elastomer. A view of the pressed surface can then be obtained by a camera enclosed within the opaque rigid shell. Light sources are placed inside the shell to illuminate the elastomer internal surface, making the sensor readings immune to external light variations, as shown in B and C. As such, the main challenge in simulating a GelSight sensor is to generate a similar internal view to the one captured by the real GelSight camera. And as we can see here in this view, this depends only on the sensor internal illumination and the membrane deformation. And so in this work we propose a novel approach for simulating GelSight sensors in the commonly used robotics simulator gazebo. Because our method is computationally cheap, it can be used for real-time or faster than real-time data collection. Simulation method. The proposed simulation method consists of two main steps. Firstly, the height map of the elastomer is computed from the depth map of the object that is in contact with the elastomer. And secondly, the internal illumination of the elastomer is computed using Phong's illumination model. For the first step, i.e. to obtain the elastomer height map, a structured light-based depth camera is placed at the same position as the RGB camera is in the real sensor. The simulated camera captures the depth image D of the object in contact with the elastomer. The obtained depth map is then thresholded by a maximum distance D max that corresponds to the maximum height that the elastomer would be able to contact, resulting in the elastomer height map age 0. This is expressed in this equation shown, where x and y is the location of the pixel D. Age 0 captures the indentation caused by the object contact with the elastomer. However, it contains sharp edges resulted from the thresholding. In contrast, the real elastomer presents smoother edges inherent from the elastic properties that generate the color gradients around the in-contact indentation. To approximate such smooth contact edges, 2D bivariate Gaussian filters, G of X and Y, are applied incrementally over age 0. In each step, G is first applied to the elastomer surface approximation from the previous step, HT minus 1, to obtain the smoothed surface HT. HT is then merged with H0 to preserve the sharp features within the in-contact regions as shown in the bottom equation. To mimic the bump contouring around the in-contact region that is observed in the real elastomer, a final height map, HDOG, is computed, where age narrow is a height map approximation computed with a smaller sigma than the one used in age wide. The results of using a single Gaussian filter versus the difference of Gaussian filters can be seen in this plot. Here in orange, the difference of Gaussians better captures the observed bump. For the second step, i.e. for generating the RGB tactile image, the Phong elimination model is used. To that extent, the height map normals, n, are computed using the discrete partial derivatives of the height map, where r is a pixel-to-meter ratio obtained through a basic calibration process. Please see the section 5D of the paper for more details about this calibration process. Finally, the tactile image can be rendered using the Phong elimination model, where L is the set of light sources, i.e. the LEDs, LM is the emission direction of a given light source M, IA is the intensity of the ambient light that is not caused by any of the LEDs, IMD, IMS are the intensities of the diffuse and spectral reflections of light source M, respectively, KA, KD, KS, and alpha are reflectance properties of the surface. RM is the direction that a perfectly reflected ray of light would take. V is the direction pointing towards the camera. Given that our camera is pointing orthogonally to the elastomer, V is set to 001. Evaluation. To produce the necessary real reference dataset, a GelSight is mounted onto a FDM 3D printer, as shown in A and C, and the corresponding simulated environment is set up in B and D. A set of small 3D printed objects is also designed and 3D printed using an SLA 3D printer. A reference dataset is then collected. For the virtual dataset, the depth maps captured by the virtual depth camera are collected, instead of the synthetic tactile images, allowing us to adjust the simulation method offline. Here you can see samples of the real and simulated images. On the top row are the real samples, then the simulation method as proposed in our previous paper, submitted to the 2019 ICRA workshop. Our revised method proposed in this work using a single Gaussian and difference of Gaussians. And finally, the simulated method parameterized for the 2017 GelSight sensor. To address the alignment gap between real and simulated images, we experiment with two different alignment approaches. The first, in which the alignment is performed globally, i.e. a single transformation is used to align all images in the dataset, and a second, in which a transformation is computed per object. three evaluation metrics are used to evaluate the alignment of the tactile images in the real dataset and the generated dataset: structural similarity, SSM, peak signal to noise ratio, PSNR, and mean absolute error, MAE. As shown in the table, with the object alignment approach, a minimal improvement is obtained for both the structural similarity, 0.859, and the mean absolute error, 8.56%, when compared to the global alignment approach. But the mean absolute error is still higher than that of the unaligned case, 8.40%. A possible reason for this is that the transformation aligns well with the salient features in the image, achieving a better structural similarity, but introduces more distortions to the images at the same time, increasing the absolute errors. Finally, we study how models pre-trained using our approach can be applied to real GelSight sensors, i.e. Sim2Real transfer learning. For this goal, we choose tactile image classification as a demonstrative task, i.e. given an image of an object in contact with a sensor, the goal is to predict what class it belongs to. One aspect to consider in the Sim2Real transfer is the Sim2Real gap that results from characteristics of the real world not being perfectly modeled in the simulation. In our case, we find that one major difference between the real and syntactic samples are the textures introduced by the 3D printing process. To mitigate this issue, we create 12 texture maps that resemble the textures observed in the real samples, as shown on the top row. By randomly perturbing the captured virtual depth maps with such textures, we are able to produce the augmented tactile images used for training, as shown on the bottom row. This provides an effective data augmentation scheme that significantly improves the Sim2Real transition from 43.76% classification accuracy to 76.19% in the real data. The model used is a convolutional neural network optimized by minimizing the categorical cross-entropy loss function. For the Sim2Real experiments, the CNN is trained using the training split of the synthetic dataset and is evaluated on the validation and test splits of the real dataset. The validation results are used for choosing the best weights, while the test split is only used for final benchmarking. Here you can see the significant improvement introduced by the data augmentation scheme. In blue, the sim-to-sim baseline. In orange, the sim-to-real without the texture augmented. And in green, the sim-to-real with texture augmented. And here, the final reported results of 76.19% versus 43.45% classification accuracy in the test split. In conclusion, we have introduced a computationally inexpensive method for simulating flat GelSight sensors that can be used to simulate GelSight sensors in real time or faster than real time, and then can be used to generate data quickly. We have shown that the method can be used for Sim2Real transfer learning, provided that the proper data augmentation scheme is used, such as the one that we followed in this paper. And in the future work, we expect to generalize and apply this method for other non-flat GelSight sensors, such as our recently proposed GelTip. If you are interested in this project or in the materials used, such as the CAD description of the 3D printed objects or the source code, please visit the webpage you see on the screen. Thank you for watching.